push the big red button. Come on.
Yeah, I just said action, fucknuts.
Oh. The winter's eve pulls off across my summer's eve, leaving only a gaping hole of the magical movements past, of Halloween's retching, falling death upon this world. Move around with the camera while you go around. Just get all sorts of different angles, like I don't know what's going on. As the falling springs of death's past come across my raven's vagina, all I know is the deathing machinations of the Springsteens of Eden are lost amongst the deathly glows of the coffin's cry. And as I sit here and drink my working man's mead, I know one day the revolution will be complete against our oppressors' thrust into our bulging pajamas, overalls, helping the engineer create his infinite scum upon the skyscraper's kiss. And I know that this cold war against the Russians will only bring death, fire, loss, disillusionment,
and carnage.
The end of everything that goes forward. Success can be achieved, but it can't be given. It must be earned. It must come from man himself. Man is a feeling creature. And for that, the best of all.
Back in Vietnam is always bring your own toilet paper. It never helped trying to use leaves. I tried to once in a while. I got some nasty rashes. But when I came back to the States, I still carry my own toilet paper everywhere. It's important, toilet paper. People don't appreciate good toilet paper these days. The Vietnamese had a very, very good brand. It was like Charmin, but it was called Fuck You White People. And it ended with so much blood and violence, so many dead people, so many turds left back in Vietnam. And in the end, all we had left was death, fire, loss.
It's great, man. When you're a little kid, you're like 3, 4, 5, you know, you're like walking around cute, and by the time you hit 6 years old, you know you're like scoring candy, right? Okay, so you get all this candy from all these people. You hit 9, 10 years old, you're like, man, I'm gonna be the biggest one. I've got this fucking pillowcase I'm gonna stack full this year. I'm gonna hit all the good houses and all that, you know. And then you get to about 13, 14, and you're thinking, why should I go through all that work? I'm just gonna take this little kid's candy, right? You know, so you mug the little kid. No, don't try this at home. It's a bad idea. I'm just saying. But, you know, and then you hit 18, 19, and then you have a kid, and then you go right back to where you were when you were 3, 4, 5 years old. You want your kid to experience the beautiful part of it. What's wrong with society is Halloween is not the same as a kid.
That no one knows the names of.
next time I'll go and wait beside a legendary fountain till I see your form reflected.
All right, we're rolling.
You know, back in the day, one of my favorite superheroes was Superwoman. Nowadays, we wonder if she is a woman.
Halloween machines, the alien machines are coming. They're gonna suck your blood. It's the new high-tech machines are coming to suck everyone's blood. They're coming in millions, like a Venom from another world. It's just a few days before they'll be here, and you're all gonna die.
What should the kids do if they're going to prepare for this when they're out getting their trick-or-treat candy?
It's too late. They're all doomed. They don't care who you are, how big you are, how small you are. They're gonna suck your blood.
What,
the machines
are
coming. The alien machines. The Halloween alien fucking machines.
They told me. They said set your clock behind. 2 o'clock. Set your clock behind. It's daylight savings time. So I set my alarm for 2 o'clock. I got up.
And you were saying?
Anyway, so as I was saying, you know how on porn sites they have romantic or passionate lovemaking clips, you know, things like that? Passionate lovemaking. What I want to know is, where's the passionate gangbang?
And the only result of Halloween would be death, fire, loss, disillusionment. The end of everything that's gone forward. Success can be achieved, but it can't be given, it must be earned. It must come from man. What was that Bob and Tom joke?
I can't remember who wrote it. It was a song that they had on there. The guy was talking about how, he was talking about daylight savings time, that he needed to set his clock back an hour at 2 o'clock. So before he went to bed, he set his alarm for 2 o'clock. It went off. He got up. He set his clock back an hour to 1 o'clock. He went to bed, and the clock went off. The alarm went off at 2 o'clock. So he got up and he set it back an hour. The alarm clock goes off. He gets up.
What does he do when the sun comes up?
sets it back. Well, he didn't get to that part, but he's like, in the song, he was talking about how, well, they didn't tell me to do it once. I was just following instructions.
He learned almost too late that man is a feeling creature. And because of it, the greatest in the universe. He learned too late for himself that men have to find their own way to make their own mistakes. There can't be any gift of perfection from outside ourselves. And when men seek such perfection, they find only death.
You were saying?
Anyway, so as I was saying, you know how on porn sites, they...
Disillusionment. In the end of everything that's gone forward, men have always sought an end through toil and misery. It can't be given, it has to be achieved. There is hope. But it has to come from inside. From man himself.